Hey y'all! In this video, I'm going to introduce a new tool for 3D modeling that's probably slightly underused and maybe slightly misunderstood, and that is the zero plane. Now, before we get into anything, I'm using Vectric Aspire version 10.012. However, everything I'm going to show you is also available in VCarve Desktop and VCarve Pro, and it works identically. Let me see if you have ever run across this kind of a situation. Then I'll show you how to fix it. We've got our 3D model created out here. It's set to the right depth. The combine mode is set correct, and we've got a vector boundary drawn around it. So we'll go ahead and select the model. I'll hold down shift. We'll select the vector. We'll come over here to calculate a 3D finishing toolpath. I have the correct bit selected. I'm machining to the selected vector right here. I have a boundary offset that's equal to the diameter of my bit. So the bit will come up out of the model and then go beyond that vector to make sure the tip of the bit goes beyond this edge just slightly. And I'm going to be machining in the offset because it is a circle. And we'll name this 3D finish. We'll calculate the toolpath. And there is our 3D finishing toolpath all set and ready to go. We'll go ahead and preview it. And with our preview completed, there we see the problem, and that is this rough, ragged edge. We look at it a little bit here, we can see just how nasty that edge looks. Let me reset the preview, and I'll show you what's going on here. Reset the preview, close that, and we'll take a look at the model. This is a dish model straight from the Vectric clip art library, but there we see the problem, and that is these jagged edges right here. You might be thinking, well, why didn't they just make a nice smooth model? Well, they probably did when they created the model, but what we have done is we've scaled the model, so something that didn't look ragged before might be a bit more pronounced since we've scaled it up. Also remember that the way the Vectric software works is these are modeled in pixels, and try as hard as you might, you are never going to get a smooth edge when you're working with pixels because pixels are square. The way to take care of this is by use of the zero plane. So let me go into a new session of Aspire and we'll start this file from scratch, and I can show you how the zero plane is going to help us out in that kind of a situation. We'll start up here by creating a new file. This is a single-sided job. My width in X is going to be 12 inches. My height in Y is going to be 12 inches. My material thickness is 3/4 of an inch. I'm setting my Z0 position to the material surface. Now, some of you may be asking, if I've set my Z0 position to the material surface, why doesn't that software know that that's my material surface and that's where I want that model to start and stop, whether there's jagged edges on the model or not? I'll explain that a little bit further in just a second. For my XY datum position, for layout purposes, I'm going to put it in the center. I do have a 3D model, and I've set my modeling resolution very high, so that we're dealing with 4 million points. I'll go ahead and click OK. And now we need to import the model. The model is straight from the Vectric clip art library, as I said. It's in the clip art, domes and dishes, and it's this model right here, the flat round circle. So I'll go ahead and double click it to import one into the center of our material. Now already we can see that the edges are a little bit rough and ragged. Because of the way these models are created, they're still going to be slightly ragged out here on the edges. That's just the nature of the beast. So we'll go back over here into our modeling tab with my model imported, and it imports already selected and in the move and transform mode. So now all I have to do is come over here under transform objects to set selected object size. Make sure I have link XY checked here, and I'm going to scale that up to 11 inches in diameter. I'll go ahead and click apply, and now we have our model scaled up to the size we need it. Then we can see the jagged edges are even more pronounced now. We'll go ahead and close that. So I have my model imported, however, it is set, the combine mode is set to merge additive. I want it to set subtractive. So I'll right click, go into combine mode, subtract. It automatically updated it. Now I want to create my vector boundary around my model. So with it selected, I'll come up here under modeling tools to create a vector boundary around the selected components. Click that icon and it draws our vector here. So we're all set. Now, if we look over here in our 3D view, we have our model placed. And there we already see those jagged edges. When we set our material thickness and our Z0 position over in Job Setup, here in the Drawing tab, that told the software where 0 is, but it did not set the boundary for where the model starts and stops. There is nothing here for this model to interact with. So the software thinks that this portion of the model is to be carved. And that's how we end up with this rough, ragged edge over here in our first example. Without any kind of a definition as to how to interact with the surface of our material, the software is going to machine this jagged edge. That's where the zero plane comes in. If we come over here to our modeling tab, I'll shoot back out to a straight Z view so we can see what happens. You'll find the zero plane up here under modeling tools, right here on the end. Add a plane component with zero height covering the model. That's exactly what it's going to do. It's going to add another component here with zero height. So we'll go ahead and we'll click that icon. And we see that our 3D view, we have now what looks like the surface of the material that we chose for our 3D preview over in Job Setup. Now if I rock this back here and take a look, the effect that is had is it has filled in those voids and there is no longer a jagged edge to be modeled. Now, when we calculate our tool paths, even though our 3D model stops down here real jagged, that zero plane is going to tell the software to calculate the tool path to come up here and then continue on up to the surface of the material. The purpose of the zero plane is to tell the component how to interact with the surface of the material. That's going to get rid of that rough, jagged edge. So, let's go ahead and zoom out to a straight Z view. We'll go back into our 2D view so I can select everything. We'll go over to our Toolpaths tab. I've got my model selected. Now I'll come over here, hold down Shift, select the vector. I'll do a 3D finishing toolpath, and I'm not going to make any changes at all up here. I've got the same bit. I'm machining to my selected vector. I've got the boundary offset the same diameter as my tool. I'm just going to change the name to 3D Finish. We'll calculate that toolpath. Our toolpath is now calculated. We'll go ahead and preview it. And there we see the difference. With our preview completed, I can rock it back, zoom in a little bit, position it down here so you can see that the addition of that zero plane has filled in those voids and we no longer have a jagged edge. The purpose of the zero plane is to tell this component how to interact with the surface of the material. So, I hope you got something out of this video. Yes, I know, it's very short, especially as compared to some of my other videos. Don't forget, today at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, I'll be hosting live Q&A session number 9, where I'll take your questions on anything that I've covered in this video. The zero plane, how it interacts with components, and how it makes those components interact with the surface of the material. Again, that will be noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern. Now, if you're not subscribed to my channel, now would be a great time to do so. And while you're at it, hit that little bell button right next to the subscribe button, then you'll get a notification every time I post a video or go live. Now, I'll put a link to the live Q&A session number 9 down in the description box below, and I hope to see you there. So again, I hope you got something out of this video and I didn't create any confusion for you. And as always, whether you subscribe to my channel or not, I'd like to thank you very much for taking the time to watch, and y'all take care.